So the background of what we're doing is basically we are looking at how bacteria are able to cause infections. So we study host pathogen interactions or ways that bacteria use to attach themselves to host tissue, because attachment to the host tissue is one of the very first steps in bacterial infection. So if bacteria can't attach themselves to host tissues, they are not able to cause infection. So one of the things we are trying to do is basically identify the mechanisms that bacteria use to stick to the tissue. They have certain sticky proteins on the surface that encourage attachment, and then we try to copy these molecules and use them as inhibitors of attachment because they are able to compete off bacteria from binding and thus prevent infections. I just find it really fascinating that microbes, bacteria, even though they are so tiny and are very efficient in terms of how they handle their information content, still can come up with ways to beat, you know, humans, which are so big compared to the tiny, tiny organisms they are. And I just find it a big opportunity for us to study the machinery that they use so very efficiently and kind of figure out what they figured out a long time ago. They've had billions of years to, you know, make the most of their machinery and to develop ways to find a perfect niche within the environment, and that they use that as a basis to cause infection now. And we just have to get, you know, more insight into the machinery that they use to find ways of fighting them. The way that our research fits into the context of saving humans is essentially we're trying to come up with new ways of treating bacterial infections. We have to do that because, as I said, bacteria become more and more resistant to antibiotics, so we really have to find altogether new strategies to treat bacterial infections. And one approach we're currently taking is to develop anti-adhesion therapy. So we're essentially copying the molecules that bacteria use to attach themselves to host tissue to make them into inhibitors of attachment, because if we bring in the molecules, they basically attach themselves to the places where the bacteria would usually go, and they prevent bacteria from attaching themselves. So they are in a way a competitive inhibitor of infections, and we can use them prophylactically to treat or prevent wound infections by multi-drug resistant strains. This is especially important because there are a lot of military personnel coming back from the fronts in Iraq and Afghanistan, and they survive the combat wounds, but they develop wound infections with multi-drug resistant organisms like Pseudomonas or Acinetobacter baumannii. And it's very hard to treat these organisms with conventional antibiotics, and it's thus especially important that we find new ways of treating these infections. So what we really hope to achieve with our research in the future is to come up with new ways of treating bacterial infections, especially in those combat-related injuries in soldiers, so that if they contract a wound in the field, usually what they do at the moment is they take a field kit that contains an ointment with conventional antibiotics. And what we hope to achieve is to have our inhibitors added to that ointment on top of the antibiotics to make it more efficient again, and to try to basically prevent wound infections before it even occurs, to try to prevent colonization of the wound by the bacteria. I hope that a few years down the line we will really see these treatments in the clinic, and I think it would be hugely rewarding to see what kind of an impact they can make on people's lives.